Okay, guys, I'm facing more of the same. They know that the wall has been penetrated. I'm telling you, a wall of understanding and pen has a wall that's held our minds back from penetrating the understanding of the word has just been penetrated. There's an understanding now that's so easy and so obvious. The spirit of Elohim moved over the semen. That's an altar in the Vatican. Angels moving over male and female reproductive systems, turning into semen. Jesus, the spirit of the self-existent eternal Jehovah is upon me. That's not the spirit of Elohim, is it? Is it? No, it's not. Okay, so there's a very obvious reality to what the Lord's delivered now. Why is the virgin a dead sheep? Jesus is the lamb that was slain before the foundation of the world. Isn't that a lamb being slain coming into the mouth of the serpent? It's yes or no. What do you think? I told you, see number three, which is angel of the bottomless pit in the Bible. The number three is, so the letter C, angel of the bottomless pit. Ovid means sheep in Latin. 19 means slaughter. So serpent, sheep, slaughter. Isn't it wild? The Vatican's a building slaughtering a sheep. Isn't it wild? Downtown Grand Junction, statue of a guy hugging a girl hugging the guy. Is a serpent slaughtering a sheep? Isn't it weird that Alex, the barista at Starbucks, drew a picture of me and it had a serpent slaughtering a sheep? Isn't it weird that a guy named Marcel drew a picture of me and it's a serpent slaughtering a sheep? Isn't it weird my wife gave me a greeting card and it's a serpent slaughtering a sheep? Isn't it weird there's commercials like the Little Deviants, Scion commercial? They come from underground, unleashing demon brothers, and they're slaughtering sheep. I mean, how many sheep being slaughtered do I need to show you? Turn the virgin upside down. It's sheep being slaughtered, I guess, because it's dead. So it's always serpents slaughtering sheep. The Vatican's a serpent slaughtering a bunch of sheep. So there's one race of beings, the serpent race, slaughtering the sheep race. So that's solved now. And they know I know. They know the Lord God's allowed me to penetrate the wall of understanding, and it's open now, and they're freaking out. My equipment's not working anymore. I'm telling you, man, for me to get not just this most recent video. We did it in a totally different way. But for the videos that I do, they are attacking different parts. They will attack the audio for anything that I pull out of a video, like that I'm going to show you. Like if I'm going to show you a clip from a video, they'll destroy the audio in it. I'll try it again. They'll destroy my audio, will not be working, even though on the program it says it's working. So they're working overtime to try and stop me from showing you this. There is an active effort to stop me from showing you the scriptures, the meaning of the word of God. There is an effort to stop me from showing you that. Think about that. Think about that. Have y'all seen the obviousness of the last video, the long one I loaded up, where the Lord let me drop the scriptures on you? They attacked that video, but Zach was able to fix it. Yeah. They're scared because they know I know. Now y'all know. Y'all should put this stuff out everywhere. I'm getting a little pissed. I can't imagine just what raging cowards they are. Raging chicken cowards. Oh, he sees us. That's why these people that leave these threats, they never show their face because they're cowards. Anyway, all right. Let me see if I can get. I'm gonna try and see if this will work. I want to play.
despite raging wars and global...
I'm going to try and play The Keys to the Kingdom by Moses the Pug, the shorty. Now watch this.
So, everyone wants to go to heaven when we die. So how do we get there? Well, the Bible tells us with the keys in Matthew 16:19.
And I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven. And whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. And whatsoever thou shalt loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven.
So Jesus gave Peter the keys to the kingdom of heaven. So what are the keys? And what did Peter say? Well, in the Acts of Peter, he told us, when he was about to die. Now remember, in John 21:19, Peter's death would glorify God. So how did Peter die?
I beseech you, the executioners, crucify me thus, with the head downward and not otherwise. And the reason wherefore, I will tell unto them that hear.
So Peter wanted to be crucified on an upside-down cross. Now, how does that glorify God? Well, it's key for understanding, and Peter told us while he hung there.
Concerning which the Lord saith in a mystery, unless ye make the things of the right hand as those of the left, and those of the left as those of the right, and those that are above as those below, and those that are behind as those that are before, ye shall not have knowledge of the kingdom.
So what are the keys to the kingdom? It's a mystery, a secret, not obvious to the understanding. It could be staring you right in front of your face and you wouldn't even know it. Purposely kept in the dark, silently mocked, hunted for dinner. It's a mystery that unlocks the kingdom of heaven. It's a mystery that unlocks the Bible. It's a mystery that unlocks eternal life.
Right there at the very, right there, right here at the very end is the most simple understanding right here. Right here, this is what it looks like. You have one eye that goes up and one eye that goes down. Jesus said, when your eyes become... If your eyes be single, your whole body is full of light. If your eye be single, your whole body is full of light. Because down is darkness, light is up. And when you turn the world upside down, the two become one. One new man from the two. And that's right out of Ephesians. And that is right out of Ephesians 2. His purpose was to make one new man from the two, thus making peace. It's the most simple thing in the world. But it's so paradoxical that someone that's an adult that's entrenched in sin and not willing to admit it, then you just can't get it because you're not willing to admit it. If you don't want to know the truth, you'll never know the truth. And it's to know the truth because Jesus is the truth. You understand? So anyway, okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to play the little short intro again one more time. I want you to think about the two little short videos. Hopefully these worked in this presentation. And then I'll at least know that I can try another longer video. I'm going to do another scripture video. It just tears the veil right off Satan completely. Just watch the little short intro that we're doing for the DVD again. Maybe look at the short video I just did that Moses the Pug did. He did that to, you know, share with us for the DVD. We're going to be using some of the gifts, and some of the little short scenes he's got. They're really good. He's got some really great skills. Anyway, so we're going to be incorporating that. Now, watch again the intro to the DVD. The greatest trick the devil ever pulled was getting the world to believe he didn't exist. Did you know there's like a, it's like a book, and it's also on Google Images. It says the greatest trick the devil ever pulled, and it has an image. Let me see if I can pull it up. I want to show you something. So if you type into Google Images, the greatest trick the devil ever pulled was getting the world to believe he doesn't exist, you get a lot of images from the movie The Usual Suspects. But here's an image that popped up, and I thought, how fascinating. So the very image that popped up, this image right here, with this court jester looking over the queen's shoulder. There's so much going on here, it's unbelievable. What's going on right here with the cat making the U, and what's really going on here is really disgusting. But what's going on right here is the whole thing. See the guy, the court jester? He's doing the shush thing. It said, and when I pulled that up, right under it said the greatest trick the devil ever pulled was getting the world to believe he doesn't exist. Well, you know what's so fascinating? Right here. Let me show you. Watch. Let me just pull it up. See the really creepy face on your screen? See it right here? There's the, all I got to do is show you the mouth. There's the mouth. There's the eyes. Here's the mouth. You see the creepy face? You know where that face comes from? That face comes from right here. There's his face. So, and she's holding a mirror, and what's looking at her in the mirror, and by the way, here in the mirror, the reflection, you see this thing smiling, but here he is doing the shush thing. That's a different mouth than right here, but when you turn this guy upside down is when you get this creepy ass picture right here, because that was the whole deal to proving that the devil does exist. All you have to do is turn the world upside down to see it. Mm-hmm. Because we got inverted when we came in to his system. So anyway, and then we became part devil, part angel. And that's the most obvious thing in the world, because the Bible says in Ephesians 2, when you walked according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit at work, and the word spirit is pneuma, and it says a superhuman angel, comma demon. So that's the spirit that's at work in you until you get converted to the Holy Spirit. This is the most obvious thing in the world. I mean, it's stupid obvious now. The Vatican's a snake. That's it. The Vatican's a snake. It's eating angels. The serpent race is eating an angelic race. Downtown Grand Junction, a statue on Main Street, whatever the Main Street is in Grand Junction, right in the middle of town. Statue, guy hugging a girl. It's a serpent killing a sheep. My wife gave me a card. Hey, Johnny, I love you. I'm sorry I've been such a biatch lately. Here's a serpent eating a sheep, by the way. Alex gave me a drawing. Hey, I drew a picture of you. Why'd you give me a serpent eating a sheep? Marcel, same thing. Drew a picture of me. Why would you draw a picture of me? Because I wanted to give you a serpent eating a sheep, which is what we're doing to y'all, Johnny. See, it's like Agent Smith moving through all the serpent race, just hunting us our whole lives. Now, that's why we didn't know what was going on. Now we know it's been penetrated. The Lord showed me, Jonathan, I've used you to penetrate it. It's like stinging them now. They're exposed. They're totally exposed. The serpent race is exposed now. It's done. The Lord showed me Revelation 4 and Revelation 5, and that he's using me now to be a conduit. Is the Vatican a snake? It's a yes or no answer. Is the serpent the enemy of God's people? Yeah. Who's the invisible boogeyman? The devil. Well, where is he? All you got to do is turn everything upside down and you can see him. Why do you think they have an upside down star as the Church of Satan? Angels are stars, and you turn the angel upside down, and you have the Church of Satan. That's it. Okay. Now, hopefully this worked. I'm going to play the little intro one more time. I want you to watch very carefully this intro and just think about it. Just look at how obvious it is. Okay, here we go. Let's do it one more time. I'm sorry. I'm really frustrated with these chickens just trying to attack this channel. It's getting old. Okay, you ready? Let's try this. Twin female system.
You never knew. That was his power. The greatest trick the devil ever pulled.
I want to show you something. In the very beginning of this intro, we showed you the whole thing. No different than the night I got saved. Jonathan, read the tags and the clothes you're carrying. I threw the first shirt down. It said 100% nylon. Doesn't make any sense. I was like, that doesn't make any sense. Maybe I've lost my mind. And the Lord said, turn it upside down. 100%. Turn the word nylon upside down. Sound it out. No lying. 100% no lying. Truth is absolute. It's the opposite direction in the system that you're in. So now watch it again. One more time. Watch. So we gave you the whole thing right here. Female energy. You turn it upside down and you see the culprit. That's why they worship the Virgin. They worship Satan.
Lucifer. You never knew. That was his power. The greatest trick. You never knew. That was his power. The greatest trick the devil ever pulled was convincing the world he didn't exist. You never knew. That was his power. The greatest trick the devil ever pulled was convincing the world he didn't exist.
Can you imagine as you're walking through your life, doing whatever it is you're doing, to actually discover who you really are and what your life was really about, and to unexpectedly find or become aware of something that you had never known, never thought, never conceived, never even imagined, and it changed the entire course of your life
forever. The discovery of one thing changed you for your eternal life. Imagine that. That's what I'm trying to show you. And what happened to me was I discovered the truth. And when I say I discovered the truth, that's exactly what I mean. I discovered the truth. In the world, a lot of people think they know a lot of truth or some truth. However, there is the truth. And Jesus said, you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. In the beginning of this quest, I'll show you something as simple as when you turn this image upside down, it becomes something totally different. Well, the Bible tells us that Elohim turned everything upside down. It says it in Ecclesiastes 7. And who can equalize that which Elohim has turned upside down? Then the question becomes, who is Elohim? Isaiah tells us, those who try and hide their plans from the Lord, they turn everything upside down.
Go to hell!
Where do you think I come from? Look into my eyes. I want to see you die.
Well, when you keep seeing the devil, aka the serpent, turning things upside down, it starts to become painfully obvious who is turning everything upside down. What about witches? They hate Jesus. Witchcraft is forbidden. That's why they have crystal balls. What about Krampus? He turns the kids upside down and steals them. As above, so below. The Masons. There's a right side up you and there's an upside down you. And that's the big sin against God. It's like taking a circular rainbow and splitting it in half. And making, instead of one eye, making one eye that's above and one eye that's below. Why do you think at all the big monuments, they have reflecting pools like the Washington Monument and like the Taj Mahal, even where the federal building bombing in Oklahoma City was blown up, they put a reflecting pool. It's very common because the as above, so below thing is simply a reference to Satan who's running the host body system.
And who do you say that I am?
I see you are the Messiah, the Son of the Living God.
I'm going to pause it right there and I'm going to go to Moses the Pugs video and show you something, because here's the representation of Jesus and Peter and the keys to the kingdom of heaven right here. I'm going to slow it down. I'm just going to go to playback speed to 0.25. Here's how simple it is. Ready? Here's what this represents you. There's a right side up you and there's an upside down you. That's the key to the kingdom of heaven right there. That is the key to the kingdom of heaven right there. And you turn 100% nylon to 100% no lion, just like the night I got saved. So the thing is, now my testimony is absolute, just stands at perfection, because I did it all those years ago. The Lord told me I had to. I didn't want to. I knew I was going to be ridiculed. I knew I was going to be totally tortured over it. I was like, no, please don't make me do it. But the Lord told me I had to, and I was obedient. Aren't you glad I did it? Now you know. You've got the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Just turn the world upside down. The way it works is, first you recognize, you see the truth, you're made aware of it, and then you accept the truth, and you ask Christ to live inside of you. You know, the word gospel means the good angel, euangelizo, the good angel, the good news. And the good news is he came and died on a cross so your duality could be reconciled and your sins could be wiped away of what you did in the flesh, because the flesh is the opponent of the Spirit of the living God. There it is. That's the whole story. Done. Now, the Lord's given me a lot of details that people have wanted to know for forever. I mean, he's shown me stuff that there's still stuff I haven't shared with y'all that's maybe PhD level stuff that's beyond most people's brains, and it gets into self-existence and unity of one, and it's so far beyond the human brain that most people, I don't even know if most people are ready for it, to be honest, because it's a real mind whapper. But what do you need to know? Well, don't you want to just know that you're going to be safe? Don't you want to know that you have eternal life? I mean, isn't that good enough? If you know that you have eternal life and you're secure in that, aren't you going to be at total peace? Of course. The goal is peace, because Christ said his purpose, he's the Prince of Peace, to make one new man out of the two, thus making peace. And then you have eternal life and peace. There'll be no more weeping, no more sorrow, no more tears. So what better gift could I give you than knowing in your heart that? And then my name means Yahweh has given. That's what Jonathan means. Well, isn't it fascinating that the Lord let me show you Jesus' name is Yehoshua, the self-existing eternal Yehovah, and the root of Yehovah is Yahweh? And I'm showing you the proof that Jesus is the self-existing eternal Jehovah that opens wide the dungeon, which is your body. I mean, it's proven now. It's been penetrated. There's no doubt about it. You can't argue with this. 350, Anacrino. So those of us that are reborn and we're spiritually reborn, we Anacrino all things. It says it in 1 Corinthians 2. Let me just show it to you one more time so you know for sure. So in 1 Corinthians 2, it says, those of us who are spiritual, so we've been born again, we Anacrino all things, vigorously judge from down to up. But the natural man, so there's a natural man that does has not been regenerated, and those are the people I deal with all the time. They're hateful, they're rude, they're cruel. They're like the people back in the days of Christ that mocked Jesus. I deal with them all the time. They call me false prophet. They say all kinds of things that aren't true, even though I've helped a lot of them, done some very amazing things to help a lot of people. And I've had some of those people turn against me because they weren't actually converted. But that's okay. That's the way it works. Here it is. But the natural man, okay, receiveth not the things of the Spirit. Now look at the word Spirit. It's new. The word is pneuma. I know it all by heart now. It's pneuma. Pneuma. It means breath, Spirit, because Spirit is breath. And it says superhuman and angel, comma demon. That's the Spirit before you get saved. But then when you get saved, your Spirit becomes not superhuman anymore. It becomes divine. And then you have God, Christ, Holy Spirit, because the two became one. So the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit, the Holy Spirit of God, for they are foolishness unto him, neither can he know them. Look at the word know. The word is very important, hinosko. There's other words that mean know. There's other words that mean K-N-O-W. One is ido, I-D-O. But this one is called hinosko, and it means to know absolutely. Okay, now let me tell you why we're on the rock. Because when you turn everything upside down, you know absolutely the truth. It's a no-brainer. I mean, is the Vatican a snake? It's a yes or no. Yes, duh. Is it eating angels? Duh. All you got to do is look. When I turn the Virgin upside down, is it a dead sheep? Yes. So I know absolutely the truth. I don't think I know the truth. I can demonstrate it to you all day long. So obvious now. Look at this. It's a self. Listen, truth is self-sustaining. Do you understand that? Truth sustains itself. No one has to. Like, people used to go to some of these channels that were Jonathan Kleck hate channels and take up for me. And I'm like, you don't have to do that. The truth is self-sustaining. Watch it. Well, I'll show it to you right now. So the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness unto him. Neither can he know them, hinosko, to know absolutely, because they are spiritually discerned. Look, anacrino, spiritually. The word spiritually right here is not, it's pneumaticos, but it means non-physically, that is divinely, figuratively, divinely discerned, okay? So you cannot, let me show you the root of the word right here. It says that is non-carnal, that is humanly ethereal as opposed to gross or demonically a spirit. So you have to be regenerated in order to be able to spiritually discern everything. That's why the number 350, I wear it on my hat. And let me show you why. Watch. Because they are spiritually, so things of the spirit, and those of us, the natural man doesn't receive them because they are spiritually discerned. Right here, ana krino. And the word ana is up right here, 303. Ana means properly up, repetition, intensity, and reversal. Up, they are spiritually discerned. And then krino, and the other part of the word ana krino, it's ana and then krino. It means to investigate and to by implication, to try, to condemn, and to punish, avenge, conclude. So when we are, listen, let me tell you something. When you are discerning all things, you know what you're really doing. You're condemning the rest of the world. Just absolutely. That's why we will judge angels, all the angels that are trapped and all the host bodies that don't turn back to God. We're going to judge them because we have been converted. So now Christ in us and the truth in us is what judges everything else. What do you think? Because now it's known. It's like, oh no, you can't tell me the Vatican's not a snake. No, sorry, no, can't do. You can't tell me that the snake's not eating a sheep. Nope, can't do it. And so the truth that lives in me, that lives in you, because Jesus is the spirit of all truth. He is the truth. You understand? So now what lives inside of us, that's why we're the smell of death to those who are perishing. That ever wonder why once you got converted, no one wants to be around you anymore? Because we're the smell of death. That's right. So now everything makes sense. Does everything make sense to you now? Does it all make sense? It all makes total sense. So here it is. So the natural man does not receive the things of the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit, for they are foolishness unto him, neither can he know them. He knows go to know absolutely, because they are spiritually discerned, non-carnally. That has to be a spiritual discernment. And the word discern is anakrino. Now watch this. But he that is spiritual judges all things. Look at the word judges. See, judgeth. He that is spiritual judgeth all things. It's anakrino as well. So that means, if you've been regenerated and you've been regenerated and you have the Holy Spirit and you've been converted, inverted, and sealed, well, then you judge all things, but you are judged of no man. That's why I laugh at these channels. I'm like, every time someone thinks they're judging me, they just condemn themselves. That's all they do. By definition, if you're calling the truth a liar and the Vatican's always a liar. Well, the Vatican's a snake. Trying to argue with it. Is it a dead sheep? Trying to argue with it. See, they can't. So they come up with like just a bunch of mouth. That's it. It's always the same nonsense. So for who hath, look at this. Who hath, ready? So the Bible says, cleanse your hearts, you double-minded. See, because if you wanted to participate in the host body system, then you have another master called Satan now, because he owns the flesh. He has title deed to the flesh. That's why there's tennis shoes that are called bait that say, fuck you, pay me. That's why, what tennis shoes say, F you, pay me on them? On a pair of shoes. Well, that's Lucifer, Satan, mocking you, saying, I gave you your host body, now pay me your soul. And then on the back of the shoes, it says lost angels. Here, let's pull them up real quick. Let's pull up a pair. Someone else tell me, why is there a pair of shoes that says this? Here, ready? Bait. Bait tennis shoes by YG. YG, if you do the math on it, like Y 25 and then G 257, it means brother of an intelligent one. Look what's on the tongue of those shoes. And it says Los Angeles. I mean, give me a break, dude. Do you understand? They're just mocking you. Satan's mocking you because you got your flesh. And now he's saying, now pay me. Because at the end of your life, you have to pay him. Or you have to have the payment of Christ on the cross to get you out of it. It's one or the other. You understand? It's like, there's no arguing it anymore. The Lord's let me penetrate it. It's been penetrated now. Bam. Done. Penetrated. The understanding is penetrated now. So, ready? For who has known the mind of the Lord? Now, remember, the Bible says, cleanse your hearts, you double-minded. The Bible says a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. But when you get converted, you are able to see, like, all the things I'm showing you, the virgin's a dead sheep, blah, 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 on and on, 70,000 images that are in the folders, and you're like, oh my God, I can see it. Now you have the mind of Christ. Did you know that? Because you had the mind of Christ and Satan at the same time. But when you get converted and you can see correctly and you anacrino all things, and anacrino means to vigorously judge from down to up. That's what the word anacrino means. And I'm going to show it to you in its expanded version. So if I anacrino all things, I judge from down to up all things, but I'm judged of no man. But now I have the mind of Christ. It says it right here in the Bible. So when people want to attack you or they want to attack me, I just laugh at them. I'm like, really? No, you're just unregenerated and you're on your way to the pit. That's it. For who hath known the mind of the Lord that he may instruct him? But we have the mind of Christ. Is that what it says there, right there? Yes or no? Does it say, for who hath known the mind of the Lord that he may instruct him? But we have the mind of Christ. So here it is. Look. So who has known, the word known is synosko, to know absolutely, the mind of the Lord that he may instruct him? Look at the word, unite in association or affection. That's what the word instruct means. To unite by a force of reduplication, unite in association or affection. And then it says, but we have the mind. Look at this, guys. We have the mind of Christ. It says the intellect, that is the mind. The understanding. So we have the understanding. But look at the word. Look, see, noose. Look at this. To hinosko, to know absolutely. So I don't think I'm converted. It's like, duh, the Vatican's a snake. Of course I'm converted. How do you think I can see it all? It's like, what did Jesus come to do? Restore the sight to the blind. I'm no longer blind. Spiritually, I see perfectly spiritually, and the enemy just can't handle it. Oh, yeah, he's a liar, he's a false prophet, they don't get him. Like, shut up. Anyway, so now it's done, it's been penetrated. The Lord showed me the other night, he took me to Revelation 4 and 5, and it's really intense stuff. The opening of the seals. So, I got really good news. Jesus is coming. For the rest of the world, I have really bad news. It's the end of the world, and it's going to be horrible. Anyway, it's a double-edged sword. Now, I love you guys in Christ. I'm really, right now, I'm hoping that this video works. I'm like, I have no idea. I've tried several right now. I've been here trying to get a video to work, and it's not working. And so I've been playing with stuff, and I'm hoping maybe this worked. And if this worked, yay. If not, I'm just going to keep trying until I uninstall, reinstall, do whatever I got to do. All right. I love you guys in Christ. Going to give it a bear hug. This is you. This is the Bear Hug Cult. I'm Jonathan Kleck, the leader of the Bear Hug Cult. We love each other. We put people ahead of ourselves in order that some may get saved. And we grab a bear that's next to us or a pillow or whatever because some of us don't get enough hugs. And it's good to know someone loves you, and it's good just to have a hug. There's a hug for all my brothers and sisters. I love you grab your pillow, hug your pillow. I'll look at you. I love you in Christ. All right. Peace and grace. So there you go. I'm proud to be called the Bear Hug Cult. No problem. Okay. All right. I want to thank everybody. God bless you guys. Thanks for stepping up always and helping this ministry when we need it. You've kept it going because I'm telling you guys, I get attacked so much. It's freaking insane. I'm like, okay. Anytime, Lord. All right. But the Lord's coming with vengeance. I have a parachute that says V for vengeance. It's V right side up and it's V upside down. V for vengeance. And I know exactly why he had me get that parachute now. And I came and I landed in Chinati, the gateway. And those are all miracles. Go look at them in the files there at the Kleck Files. All right. I love you guys in Christ. I'm hoping this worked. Peace and grace. And we'll keep you up to speed on all the video production stuff. I'm not going to show it all to you, but we're going to give you like little, you know, snippets like we did tonight. And Moses, thanks for sending some cool stuff. All right. Anybody wants to send stuff, you know, if you're trying to, people try and contact me, guys, I would love to be able to hang out with everybody like Night at the Stars. I would, but I am so stacked with just this. I've got so many scriptures I need to give you guys. It's crazy. And I need to do like a night where I make a record of just scriptures. So they're out there in the domain. The Lord's let me penetrate the understanding of the Bible, obviously. I mean, the spirit of Elohim moved over the seamen. The whole altar in the Vatican is the spirit of Elohim, angels moving over the seamen. That's what the whole thing is. The light beings coming in, turning into flesh beings. That's what it is. And Jesus said the spirit of the Lord God, self-existing eternal Jehovah, is upon me. So you don't have to wonder about the spirit of Elohim and the spirit of the Lord God. Who's who and what's what? And I see people, well, that's not the, you know, the Ruach Kodesh or whatever. And I'm like, guys, you know, go look up the meaning of Holy Spirit. Just go look it up. You know what? I'll do it for you. So cast me not away from thy presence. Look at the word presence. Look at this. It means cast me not away from thy presence. Here we go. It's panim. See right here, panim, the face as the part that turns. So when you turn back to God, you see God. You're seeing God. Do you understand when you turn back? That's why in the Genesis 1, it says, and the spirit of Elohim moved up above the face of the waters, the face as the part that turns. Genesis 1, the spirit of Elohim moved over the face as the part that turns of the waters, the semen. That's what the whole altar is in the Vatican. Okay, so here you go now. Ready? Cast me not away from thy presence. What's thy presence? Thy face as the part that turns right there. So thy face is presence. Take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Look at the word Holy Spirit right here in the Old Testament. It's Kadesh. See it? A sacred place or thing, rarely abstractly sanctity, consecrated thing, dedicated thing, portion. Okay, so when people, you know, think, oh, well, you're supposed to pray to the Ruach Kodesh, whatever, it's like, that's nonsense. No, I don't know who told you that. You pray to the Lord God through Jesus. Jesus is our connection on the cross back to El, the Almighty God. He's the restoration of the connection back to the Lord God. And people, oh, you have to say, you know, the Ruach Kodesh. I'm like, that's just nonsense. I don't know where you guys come up. Some of these guys come up with that stuff, but it's just nonsense. So take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Look, holy, what does holy say? Okay, it says Kodesh, a sacred place or thing. Okay, there you go. It's a sacred place or thing. That's what the word Kodesh means. Okay, so they're referring to the spirit, the sacred. What is that sacred spirit in Jesus? What is it? It's a self-existing eternal Jehovah that breathed into Adam, his man, the breath of life, and man became holy. A man became a living soul. I've done my homework. The Lord's the one that had me do my homework. Okay, he's the one that gave me my homework. So anyway, so here it is. Take not thy Holy Spirit from me. And there's the Ruach. See it? Ruach. So when people think, oh, I'm praying to the Ruach Kodesh, it's like this is just a word describing a spirit. Okay? The spirit is the spirit of the Lord God is upon me. That's the spirit of the Lord God, self-existent. Do you know why it's self-existent? Because if you're the Lord God and you allow Elohim to have free will and they start a system and then you put all the souls into that system, everybody's walking around with their little spark from the Almighty. Everybody gets it. You're all walking around with it. And then he comes into the system through a virgin. He dies on the cross to buy back any of those little sparks he can buy back, and they get to go back. Self-existent. You get it? He's buying himself back because he's the one that gave you the spark. He's the father of lights. El is the father of us. We're spirits before we're flesh. Where do you think we come from? Okay. All right, guys. I hope this really sinks in. The Lord God has let the guy talking to you penetrate the enemy's veil. It's done. It's done. It's penetrated. You showed me for sure last night. It's like you've accomplished that now. Woo! Woo! Okay. All right. I love you guys. All right. I'm really a little bit frustrated right now because it's been a crazy 2 days and this computer stuff is starting to really, it's tough coming out here and doing a couple hours of video and then it's gone. All right. Let's see what happened. I don't want to do any more because if it doesn't work, then I'm going to be even more frustrated. Okay. I love you in Christ. One more bear hug. It's the bear hug cult. We might switch it to the lion hug cult next week. There you go, because the Lion of the Tribe of Judah is coming. All right, love you in Christ. Hug your pillows. Hug, give Johnny a hug. Okay, I love you guys. Peace and grace. All right. All right, guys, here we go. The King's coming. He's coming.